Hello, everybody! What's going on? This is Will here, and we are what look to be very crushed up snowflakes. Oh, God. Oh, it's beautiful. Alright, so anyway, in the last episode of Pokémon HeartGold, we started doing the rematches. Of course, being select gym leader rematches that are required to do the friggin' in-game trades, because I'm going to show off all those, and once I have shown off all the in-game trades, we're going to go for the final fight, and we're going to wrap up the Let's Play. Isn't that nuts to think about? This next one, we're going to be getting a hold of Brock, and we'll be doing our rematch with him in order to do an in-game trade with him. So, his team is going to be pretty easy. I don't even think I need to look at it, because it really is that straightforward of a team. I mean, obviously I fought with Michelle Ruff in the last gym leader fight with him, and I basically wiped his entire team out with Michelle Ruff. So now that Michelle Ruff's actually evolved, Brock really does not have much going for him. Let's face facts here. So it'll be a super easy fight, super straightforward. And then we'll get the in-game trade done. I'm still kind of actually fuzzy on what the actual in-game trade is. I could go back to check now, but good lord, I can't be arsed. Anyway, you have to come here on a Saturday afternoon, I believe. Or no, any day between 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And then his rematch window is Saturday night. I'm pretty sure that's how it works. So Brock is like, small spaces surrounded by rocks make you feel peaceful, don't you agree? Yeah, actually, I kind of do agree. By the way, do you want to exchange numbers? Yeah, man. Dude, I'll call you up for awesome cooking that apparently you do. Because the show says you're a good cook. I would love to have a Pokemon battle against you. Give me a call on Saturday nights. Sweet, man. That's awesome. Thank you. Oh, that's so great. Cool. Alright, well, now, of course, we have to use our lovely clock here. I'll just make a cut. We'll cut to Saturday night. Actually, I guess I don't even have to make a cut. I thought the windows were gonna like get in the way and obstruct everything, but I guess not. So let's do 9:48 p.m. Yeah, look at that. Hey Liz, what's up, brah?
Evening, how are you doing? This is Liz. Hi Tanya, how are you?
You always call, do Tanya and I have like similar numbers? What is going on here? There is some kind of conspiracy going on. Liz is like secretly a telemarketer, and she like secretly buys my information and tracks me every time she calls me. she's really notorious like that. Sorry, gotta start doing this. I'll go right to Saffron now, since that's all I gotta go to really. So I'll just head on over to Saffron. Ba-boom. As you can see, I still have Shotgun on my team. I need him for Fly now, since Joel has been traded away for the level 70 Steelix Rusty, which was owned by Jasmine. So, we gotta put Michelle Ruff in the front here. There we go. And now we gotta call Brack. Oh, what am I doing? Map screen. Too many flashbacks of catching Tier Grants. Oh my lord, man. So Brock should be near the bottom, because that's where the gym leaders always go. Yeah. Hello, what's up? I'm doing great. Hey, you called me at just the right time. I'm free right now. Want to battle me again? Hell yeah, I do. All right, I'm looking forward to it. I'll meet you at the Fighting Dojo in Saffron City. I won't be at the Pewter Gym, all right? Don't get confused. Aw, man, I like the way Brock explains it. He's very comprehensive about his explanation of this. Because I could see this being, like, you know, potentially confusing for some people to try to do and, like, arrange and everything. So it's kind of nice that Brock just laid it all out for it. Like, leave it to Brock, right? Just, like, the coolest guy, man. The dude I would totally hang out with in real life. IRL. IMO. LOL. Okay. All right, time to fulfill our promise. Oh, God. Brock, apparently you have a speech impediment. I'm so sorry. Dude, I still love his outfit. That is such an awesome outfit. I want that shirt. I really do. Alright, first Pokemon's Golem. I think I might have the advantage. I just might have the advantage right here. Faster. I have a stab move that the opponent is quadruple weak to. I might have the advantage here. and a critical hit just to add insult to injury. Alright, well. Yeah, I think we've got this in the bag. Ooh, Rampardos, though. Ooh. Okay. Let's see. Let's throw up Reflect, just to be safe. Because, well, I know I shouldn't have done that. Rampardos is probably going to friggin' wreck me now. Oh, it's got Rock Polish. That's interesting. So yo gonna double yo speed. Let's just go right for the Magical Leaf then. Oh god, Stone Edge. That will be painful. Especially because Rampardos has, like, crazy attack power. It's Pokemon from Sinnoh. Crazy attack. Pretty fairly low everything else, though. So that's kind of the trade-off. But he has Rock Polish to offset the awful speed, so... Oh, that didn't do anything, though. Not with Reflect Up, at least. Without Reflect Up, that would have hurt a lot, but... Yeah, that didn't suck too bad at all. Alright. That was actually kind of candy-ass when you think about it. Good lord. Rampardos is supposed to be, like, notorious for its high attack, and... Even with Reflect Up, you'd think it would still at least, like, half killers. Anyway, whatever. I won't overthink it. Why would I question something when I'm winning? Because there's half the team gone right there. Relicanth, a Pokemon from Hoenn. Kind of an eh Pokemon. It's got, like, some HP bulk, but, again, it's kind of like the Rampardos deal. High HP, low everything else. Kind of, like, not low, like, middling. I don't know. It was Stunfisk before Stunfisk. Let's face facts. We've got an Onix, level 61 Onix. That's pretty neat. Too bad it's dead, but, I mean, I have your evolved form. Grossly superior, I'm sorry to say. In this generation, at least. Depending on its role on a team, I would say that a Violite Onix is on par with Steelix. Depending on what you need it for. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at them stats. Oh, Michelle Ruff, you're so good. You're so good. Gotta watch out for this Kabutops. I remember the last time in this friggin' fight, I got all scared and flustered because I thought it might have had X-Scissor. I still don't know if it does or not. I don't friggin' know. But either way, Kabutops is done. This is gonna be a super short episode. Good lord. I'm recording this, like, right before I go to classes and stuff for college today, so I'm, like, just squeezing this in here. But, I think that's fine. Whatever. That's alright. Oh, Protect? Are you serious? Oh, come on. There we go. Alright. We beat him. Yeah, enough joking around, Brock. Right? Enough joking around. You did get an attack on me. You did get one Stone Edge. So there is that. There is that. Okay. Looks like you're the stronger one. That's right, man. I beat you. I've lost again. You aren't adventuring around for nothing. Gosh, I'm so sorry about that. I'm just so sorry. So now we gotta do the in-game trade with them. That's the final step here. Let's see here. Well, first things first, we should fly back to Pewter to see if this is where we do the trade. And if not, then we probably have to meet him back at the Diglett Cave, I would assume. That's what I'm guessing, at least. I might be completely wrong in thinking all this. But, that's why we're gonna go and find out, you know? That is why it is happening. So let's go on into the gym here. Oh yeah, look at that, what a throwback. What a throwback roughly 10 to 15 episodes ago. The world is huge, there's still many strong trainers like you, just wait and see. I'm gonna become a lot stronger too, okay. So he's just saying his little gym leader spiel here. So, I would say we probably have to meet him at Diglett Cave again. Which is totally cool. That's fine. So we'll just do this again. And boom. And now it's daytime. Awesome. All right. That must be really weird to see. Like, just to see it, like, instantly turning from night to day. Because you never see that in the actual game normally. Because it would always go to, like, to dawn and then today. Like, you know, it always start in the morning. I don't know. Gotta switch some Pokemon around here. The shortest way to getting it to where Brock is right now would be using Elmer for a cut. So, just throw Elmer onto the team nice and quick. See, look at this, man. We're rotating our team around. Everyone is useful in their own way. Yes, even you, Usher, okay? Even Usher is useful in her own way. Alright? She can right hit music. Or if I'm thinking of the wrong Usher, she can pretend to be the guy who writes hit music. So there is that. She can get all the bitches. I feel like I might have done something wrong here. I may have miscalculated. One sec, guys. Alright, so I just read up on it. I'm all refreshed now. Anthony wants to battle. He is totally on after this episode. But basically what I want to close this with saying is we're going to get the next rematch done in the next episode, but we're still going to round up for the in-game trades, and I'll show you what you have to do. You have to talk to Brock, who will appear at the entrance of Diglett Cave between 5 and 8, I believe it was. So he'll pop up here on Saturday nights, and he'll start talking to you. Hi, Will! Have you seen a Pokemon called Bonsly? Then you have to get it from, they say you have to get it from an egg. I am having a hard time finding one. If you happen to have a Bonsly, could you trade it for my Rhyhorn? Well, I don't have one right now. But, you know, we'll still get one. And, I do want to show off this specific in-game trade, because there's something very special about the Rhyhorn you get from him. But until we get that done, that is the end of the episode. Come back in the next episode, we're going to do the next rematch, the third and final one against Lieutenant Surge. Hopefully we'll get his in-game trade done as well. Actually, his is pretty simple, so we'll definitely get his done. And then the episode after that, we'll actually do like a big old roundup episode of all the leftover in-game trades we still have to do. So that'll probably be a big like 20-25 minute one, so I'm prefacing that right now so you guys can choose whether you want to skip it or not. Pretty much. But other than that, I hope you all have a very good life. Or afterlife, if you are Will after college today. In the next episode, it's going to be a tiring day. A very tiring day, indeed. It'll be worthwhile, I'm sure. Maybe. Kinda. Sorta. Peace.